हेलो नमस्कार एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस कल का सेशन नहीं हो पाया था बिकॉज ऑफ सम टेक्निकल अपग्रेडेशन इन माय सिस्टम, बट अब से ये सेशन प्रॉपरली होता रहेगा मंडे टू फ्राइडे एट 8 AM, राइट। एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द खादी अगरबत्ती आत्मनिर्भर मिशन। अगरबत्ती मीन्स इंसेंस स्टिक्स, राइट। सो खादी अगरबत्ती आत्मनिर्भर मिशन दैट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट। So we will discuss this and we are also going to discuss about the recommendations of high level expert group on agricultural exports. Agricultural exports पे एक high level expert group बनाया गया था, उसकी कुछ recommendations आई हैं, तो उन recommendations में से जो जो most important recommendations है, we are also going to discuss in today's session. Alright, so do watch the complete session. Now guys, question number 1 and 2 are based on the high level expert group on agricultural exports. So let us first discuss the news, then we will move on to the question. Okay, so there was one high level expert group on agricultural exports that was set up by 15th France Commission, and this committee, this group was set up to recommend performance incentives for states to encourage agricultural exports. Yani ki jab jo states hain unko encourage kiya jayega that you should promote agricultural exports so that we will provide you and in return we will provide you the incentives. Okay, aisa central government karegi for the states, right? Matlab the states will be encouraged to promote exports in their respective state and in return they will be provided with the performance incentives, all right. And this group has also recommended the promotion of crops to enable high import substitution. जो हमारे देश का import है उसको कम करना है, export को increase करना है, और जिसके लिए हमें कुछ crops है उनको promote करना पड़ेगा. And 15th Finance Commission guys chairperson is Mr. N.K. Singh. And now let's talk about some most important recommendations of this group. So number one is that there will be focus on 22 crop value chains with the demand driven approach. You must not remember all these 22 crop value chains. इसकी पूरी लिस्ट आपको याद करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है, बस आपको इतना पता होना चाहिए that there will be focus on 22 crop value chains with the help of demand driven approach, right? And there will be creation of state led export plan with participation from various stakeholders like private agencies, commodity holders, commodity boards, गवर्नमेंट एजेंसी, कोऑपरेटिव एजेंसी, इन सभी की मदद लेते हुए, इन सभी की पार्टिसिपेशन के साथ एक स्टेट लेड एक्सपोर्ट प्लान बनाया जाएगा और जिसको अकॉर्डिंगली फॉलो करते हुए जो एक्सपोर्ट है उनको बढ़ावा दिया जाएगा, राइट। एंड ऑल्सो प्राइवेट सेक्टर शुड प्ले एन एंकर रोल। प्राइवेट सेक्टर का जो रोल है वो बढ़ाना चाहिए हमें एज पर द रिकमेंडेशन ऑफ दिस ग्रुप। एंड सेंटर शुड बी एन एनेबलर, जो सेंटर है वो एनेबलर की तरह काम करेगा, यानी कि द स्टेट्स विल फॉर्मुलेट द प्लान एंड जो सेंटर है उसमें एनेबलर का काम करेगा, ओके। एंड देयर शुड बी अ रोबस्ट इंस्टीट्यूशनल मैकेनिज्म टू फंड एंड सपोर्ट इंप्लीमेंटेशन। फंडिंग के लिए और सपोर्ट करने के लिए एक पूरा इंस्टीट्यूशनल मैकेनिज्म होना चाहिए ताकि जो हमारे एक्सपोर्ट्स हैं इंक्रीज किए जा सके, ओके। एंड व्हाट इज द स्टेट लेड एक्सपोर्ट प्लान? सो गाइस दिस प्लान विल ले आउट द अपॉर्चुनिटी, इनिशिएटिव एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट दैट आर रिक्वायर्ड टू मीट द डिजायर्ड वैल्यू चेन एक्सपोर्ट, ओके। जो भी हमारा एक्सपोर्ट है उसको बढ़ावा देने के लिए जो जो अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैं, जो जो इनिशिएटिव्स हैं और जो जो इन्वेस्टमेंट रिक्वायर्ड है उन सभी का जिक्र होगा इस प्लान में। एंड व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स दैट आर नीडेड टू बी कंसीडर्ड बाय फॉर्मुलेटिंग दिस प्लान? सो नंबर वन इज दैट द प्राइवेट सेक्टर प्लेयर्स एंड कमोडिटी बोर्ड्स शुड बी इंक्लूडेड व्हाइल फॉर्मुलेटिंग प्लान। जो प्राइवेट सेक्टर प्लेयर्स हैं और जो कमोडिटी बोर्ड्स हैं उन सभी को इंक्लूड किया जाएगा इस प्लान को फॉर्मुलेट करने के लिए। एंड व्हाट रोल डिड विल प्राइवेट सेक्टर प्लेयर्स प्ले? सो प्राइवेट सेक्टर प्लेयर का काम गाइस, फॉर एग्जांपल इफ वी से दैट प्राइवेट सेक्टर प्लेयर ने कोई एक ऐसी मशीन बनाई, राइट, इस मशीन को सब्सिडाइज रेट पे फार्मर्स को प्रोवाइड कराया, ओके, एंड जिससे कि फार्मर्स का जो काम है, वर्कलोड है वो थोड़ा सा इजी हो गया एंड जो क्रॉप की जो एफिशिएंसी है या जो क्रॉप का प्रोडक्शन है दैट हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड। सो अगर क्रॉप्स की प्रोडक्शन इंक्रीज होगी देन ओनली द एक्सपोर्ट्स कैन बी इंक्रीज्ड। सो दिस इज हाउ a private player can help in the promotion of exports of agricultural goods, okay. And number two is center should enable state led plans. Next is institutional governance should be promoted across state and center. Jo state aur center hai unke beech ka institutional governance hona chahiye so that jo state led plans hai unko jo center hai wo enable kar sake. And funding jo hai wo honi chahiye through the convergence of existing schemes, finance commission allocation and private sector investment. So this is about the स्टेट लेड एक्सपोर्ट प्लान। एंड नाउ इस ग्रुप ने, इस हाई लेवल एक्सपोर्ट ग्रुप ने एक एस्टिमेशन दिया है। दिस ग्रुप हैज एस्टिमेटेड some numbers. Like for example, they have estimated that in the agricultural sector there will be investment of $8 to $10 billion in coming few years, and the exports will be rise to $70 billion in coming few years, and it will also help in job creation of 7 to 10 million. If the agricultural exports are increased, it will help in job creation of 7 to 10 million, as per the recommendation, as per the estimation of this high-level export group. Okay, and now, guys, let's move on to the question number 1 and 2. Recently, high-level expert group on agricultural exports was set up by Finance Commission. With respect to the recommendations of the committee, identify the incorrect statement. So we have to find the incorrect statement regarding the recommendations of the committee. So statement number 1 is private sector players should not be included while formulating the state-led export plan. So no, guys, this is incorrect. क्योंकि इस ग्रुप ने ये रिकमेंड किया है कि जब हम स्टेट लेड एक्सपोर्ट प्लान बनाएंगे देन प्राइवेट सेक्टर एंड कमोडिटी बोर्ड शुड बी इंक्लूडेड वाइल फॉर्मुलेटिंग द प्लान राइट सो दिस स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट डिमांड ड्रिवन अप्रोच शुड बी फॉलोड यस एंड देर विल बी फोकस ऑन 22 क्रॉप वैल्यू चेन्स एंड वैल्यू एडिशन शुड बी फोकस्ड ऑन यस दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट सो गाइज जो हमारा इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट है दैट इज ओनली वन सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी व्हाट ऑप्शन डी एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 With respect to the estimation provided by HLEG on agri exports, identify the correct statement. Now we have to find the correct statement regarding the estimation that has been provided by this group. So statement 1 is estimated investment in agricultural export will be around $8 to $10 billion. Yes, this is absolutely correct. There will be creation of 7 to 10 million jobs. Yes, and in few years India's agricultural exports can rise to $100 billion. No, it is not 100 billion. It will rise to $70 billion. So we have only one incorrect statement, that is statement number 3. So therefore the correct answer will be what? Option D. And now guys, let's move on to the next news, which is about the promotion of startups in the agricultural area. So let's read out the question. Under which scheme Ministry of Agriculture will promote the innovation and agripreneurship, thereby promoting startups in the area of agro processing, food technology and value addition. So recently guys, Ministry of Agriculture ने startups को encourage किया है in the field of agriculture under the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. Under the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, the innovation and agripreneurship component will be promoted, thereby encouraging the startups in the field of agro processing, food processing and in the other areas of agriculture. And guys, Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana was launched in the year 2008 by NDC, National Development Council. Iski formulation 2007 se hi shuru ho gayi thi, but it was formally launched in the year 2008. All right. And jo baad mein isko Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana ko update karke RKVY Raftar mein change kar diya gaya tha. Okay. RKVY Raftar. So now RKVY Raftar is the full name of the scheme. And he is Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. He is the Minister of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare, Government of India. And if we talk about the key points of this initiative, so guys, in the first phase, 112 startups will be promoted in the area of agro processing, food technology, food processing and value addition. So initially 112 startups hai jinko promote kiya jayega by the ministry, and for this a sum of rupees 1185.90 lakh. You should not remember this scheme. Ye number aapko yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. You must not remember this number. Okay, so 1185.90 lakhs will be provided in the installments in the first phase for the promotion of these startups. And for this, for the implementation of this initiative, Department of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare has selected 5 knowledge partners as the centers of excellence and 24 agribusiness incubators. Agribusiness incubators ko aur knowledge partners ko select kar liya gaya hai by the Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Okay. And guys, if you talk about the RKVY Raftar scheme, so RKVY, we all know, Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, and Raftar stands for Remunerative Approaches for Agriculture and Elite Sector Rejuvenation. Okay, you should remember this full form. Remunerative Approaches for Agriculture and Elite Sector Rejuvenation is the full form of Raftar, and the main objectives, guys, of this scheme is to provide pre and post harvest agricultural infrastructure to farmers so that उनकी जो crop production है उसको enhance किया जा सके, and also जो भी उनकी income है उसको बढ़ाया जा सके, and also to provide autonomy, flexibility to states to plan and execute schemes as per the local needs. जो भी local needs है farmers की उसके हिसाब से जो स्टेट्स हैं उनको ऑटोनॉमी और फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी प्रोवाइड कराई जाती है स्कीम के अंदर, एंड टू मिटिगेट द रिस्क ऑफ फार्मर्स विद फोकस ऑन एडिशनल इनकम जनरेशन एक्टिविटीज, एंड ऑल्सो टू एम्पावर यूथ थ्रू स्किल डेवलपमेंट, इनोवेशन एंड एग्री एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. ओके, सो दीज आर सम ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द आरकेवीवाई रफ्तार स्कीम. And now, guys, let's move on to the question number 3, which is about the promotion of startups in the Ministry of Agriculture, in the field of agriculture, if we say it. So, the question was, under which scheme Ministry of Agriculture will promote the innovation and agripreneurship, thereby promoting the startups? So, guys, we have discussed this. The scheme is what? Option C, Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana. Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana ke antargat is initiative ko promote kiya jayega. And now, some of you will confuse between Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana and Raftar. So guys, Raftar is one of the component of RKVY. The umbrella scheme is what? RKVY, Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, and therefore the correct answer is what? Option C. Now let's move on to question number 4, which is about the Scotch Gold Awards. So the question is, which ministry or organization has recently won the Scotch Gold Awards for providing IT-enabled scholarship to students? IT-enabled scholarship provide karane ki liye, kaun si ministry ya kaun si organization ko Scotch Gold Awards mila hai? So guys, Scotch Gold Awards were instituted in the year 2003, and these awards are given to those people, to those institutes, to those organizations who have done something great for making India a better place to live in. Okay, so or yes, Scotch jo hai guys, it is basically an independent organization. Ye koi government organization nahi hai, na hi koi public private organization hai. All right. So recently guys, Ministry of Tribal Affairs received this Scotch Gold Awards for empowerment of tribals through IT-enabled scholarship scheme. And guys, Ministry of Tribal Affairs is headed by Mr. Arjun Singh Munda. Arjun Munda. His Lok Sabha constituency is Khunti, which is in Jharkhand. Okay. And this time, the competition, the Scotch 2020 competition was entitled as India Response to COVID through Digital Governance. The title was India Response to COVID through Digital Governance. Okay. And what are the key points of this award of this Ministry of ट्राइबल अफेयर ने जो अवार्ड जीता है, क्यों जीता है, किस वजह से जीता है, ये उसके कुछ की पॉइंट्स हैं. सो मिनिस्टर ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स हैज इंटीग्रेटेड 5 स्कॉलरशिप स्कीम्स विद द डीबीटी पोर्टल, देयर बाय प्रमोटिंग डिजिटल इंडिया. एंड इन द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2019-20 दे हैव प्रोवाइडेड रुपीज 2500 करोड़ डायरेक्टली टू द स्टूडेंट्स बैंक अकाउंट्स. ओके, एंड जो पीएचडी के लिए फेलोशिप स्कीम है, इन द फेलोशिप स्कीम फॉर पीएचडी ऑल द 331 यूनिवर्सिटीज हैव बीन इंटीग्रेटेड विद द पोर्टल. And the portal, guys, is also integrated with the DigiLocker, so that the documents are directly fetched and saves verification time. So these are some key points. And now, guys, let's move on to the question. So the answer is clear now. Option C, Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Ministry of Tribal Affairs is the correct answer. Now let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. So Khadi Agarbatti Atmanirbhar Mission has been launched recently for the boost of Agarbatti production, supporting the vocal for local. With respect to the mission, identify the correct statement. So we have to identify the correct statement with respect to the mission. Okay. So now let us first discuss about this mission. So recently, Ministry of MSME has approved a program which is named as Khadi Agarbatti Atmanirbhar Mission. And this program, guys, was proposed by KVIC. KVIC is headquartered in Mumbai and it is headed by Vinay Kumar Saxena. Okay. And this mission has twin objectives of creating employment for the unemployed and those migrant workers which were affected due to the COVID-19 in different parts of the country, and also to increase the domestic agarbatti production. Jo hamari domestic agarbatti production hai usko increase karne ke liye, and also jo migrant workers hain aur jo unemployed hain unko employment provide karane ke liye is mission ko launch kiya gaya hai. And these are some important provisions of this scheme, guys. So number one, the most important is that the scheme is designed on PPP mode, the public private partnership mode. And under this scheme, the KVIC, Khadi Village and Industry Commission, will provide automatic agarbatti making machines and powder mixing machines. Okay, and for this only made in India machines will be procured. Keval made in India, keval locally made machines jo hongi wahi procure ki jayengi, bahar se kisi machine ko import nahi kiya jayega. Okay, and KVIC will also provide 25% subsidy on the cost of the machines, and the rest of the cost will be recovered. Will be recovered in installments by the artisans. जो भी artisans हैं उनसे 75% of the cost जो है वो installments में ली जाएगी, और बाकी जो 25% है उसका subsidy provide कराया जाएगा by the KVIC. एंड जो आर्टिसन है गाइज उनको ट्रेनिंग प्रोवाइड कराई जाएगी ऑन हाउ टू ऑपरेट दीज ऑटोमेटिक अगरबत्ती मेकिंग मशीन्स एंड पाउडर मिक्सिंग मशीन्स एंड फॉर विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम प्राइवेट पार्टनर्स एंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ दैट ट्रेनिंग विल बी शेयर्ड बिटवीन केवीआईसी एंड द प्राइवेट पार्टनर्स इन द रेशो ऑफ 75:25 Every artisan will be able to earn at least ₹300 per day using the automatic agarbatti making machines and using powder mixing machine. Each artisan will get a fixed amount of ₹250 per day. Okay, ₹250 हर दिन के वो कमा सकता है. So these are some guys important provisions of this scheme. And if we talk about the KVIC, so it was set up by KVIC Act of 1956. Current chairman is Mr. Vinay Kumar Saxena. This handsome is Mr. Vinay Kumar Saxena. Headquarters are in Mumbai and it has some huge objectives of providing employment to the unemployed and it has economic objective of producing sellable articles and it also has the wider objective of creating self-reliance amongst the poor and building up of a strong rural community and these days it has a more wider objective of promoting vocal for local as announced by the Prime Minister in the Atmanirbhar mission. All right. So now let's move on to the question, guys. Question is, it has two objectives of creation of employment and increment of agarbatti production. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Only locally made machines will be procured. Yes. And KVIC will provide 25% of subsidy on the cost of machines. Yes. 25% will be provided by KVIC and 75% will be recovered from the artisans in installments. All right. So all the statements are correct. So therefore, option E will be the correct option. Okay guys, so that's it for the session today. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Aapko ye session kaisa laga? Guys, comment karke zarur bataye. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.